This series is called The Last Dance of the Leaves. I used to be a dancer. I met my ex-wife through dance, and what started off as a fabulous journey is continuing now, though I've not seen her in 16 years. She broke up with me 10 years, 16 years back after a 10-year marriage. This is the cathartic process that got me to becoming one of the happiest people I know. And it started off while backpacking in Paris and went through 12 countries from there, shooting leaves in autumn around 15 years back. And I've never seen anything die so beautifully. So this became an exploration of figuring out how do they die so beautifully, how to die beautifully. And I was like, maybe to just die beautifully, that's all you have to do is live a beautiful life. These are all depictions of various human relationships that have affected me. I'm an amalgamation of all the relationships I've ever had in my life. And this particular piece is of a friend of mine called Divya, who I've known for much, 16 years old. She's a lovely girl. Little unassuming thing, blend with the crowd, you know. So this is her blending with the crowd. It's a gift that she gave me during a workshop. And I still have those flowers. This is her blending with the crowd, but still it's beautiful. But when you take her out, and you take a human being and put them separately, and you spend some time with them, and you get up close with them, and you allow them to communicate with you, you get layers getting peeled off, and then the light shines through. That's the depiction of this one. This particular one is how I interpret when I see a beautiful aging dancer, like maybe Chandralekha or Sarojini Devi. You know, like you just see how beautiful they look, even as they age. There's a grace in it, you know. We associate age and death with wrinkling up and struggling, but this is not that, this is beautiful. This, for me, all these are little images of us dancing, because for me, I realized that for a leaf, the beauty is just that when the wind comes in the end, they're all dressed in the best outfits, and if the wind takes them to their love, they get to dance for a little time between the branch and the earth. That's their moment of love. That's all they need. Maybe that's all I needed too. So this was all exploration of all the ways that my ex-wife Shamshana used to dance. Then it became people that I would like to dance with, all the people that I would love to interact with. This particular shot is interesting for me because it's actually a depiction of how the stars would look down upon us when we should lay down and stare at the stars. So that's a depiction of that. And if you can come along with me, this is actually a different way of looking at it. This is a family. It's not necessarily just two people. It's not just about you know, just you and your lover or anything else. So it's like all kinds of relationships. So this is a beautiful little family. The other thing I did was, like, apart from exploring leaves, human relationships through leaves, I also explored how we could depict life of a leaf through humans. And I realized I've shot 78 nudes over 15 years of 78 different people, but all I needed to use was just around 7 to 8 of them, because the life of a leaf is so simple. And that's what's beauty about it. So this particular one is the hanging, that human over there is a hanging leaf. That's a leaf falling. And all those over there are when they first touch the ground and they dance into the earth. It's not, they never just fall flat, they all dance into the earth. So this is the process of the dance. Before she settles into the earth, and then they would go back in, obviously, and resurface as a new form. So that's what's happened to me. I've gone into the earth, I've come back. This is my rebirth, and I'm up there in the tree again, looking at the next leaf saying, hey babe, you wanna dance?